Hello, this is Bern, and if you're interested in finding out how you can go deeper with men, both in your level of communication and your level of connection, well, this video is for you, so stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams, the level of connection that you want, without gimmicks, without manipulation, without stupid games, and as a result of stepping into the most alive, most passionate, and most feminine version of yourself. Look, a lot of women reach out to me in the middle of a crisis, and the crisis sometimes is, I am connecting with this guy and I can't read him. I really can't get a sense of who he is and what he wants, and I really like him, but I'm not sure if we can go forward, or I'm already in a relationship, but I don't feel like I really know who I'm with. I feel like he's holding back. I feel like he's not sharing what he needs to share with me, and I have no idea how to change it. Or when I connect and I go on dates, first, second, third date, it's taking me a long time to connect. It's like we're having these conversations, but they're not feeling deep to me, and I want more than what I'm feeling right now. If you find yourself into any of those categories or all of the above, then what I'm going to share with you right now is going to help you. First principle is there is no magic question. There is no strategy. There is no crazy technique that can replace the emotional state that you are in when you have that level of connection with a man. Whether you're going on a date, whether you're making love, whether you're evaluating if somebody's the right fit, on any given setting, connect with him at the grocery store. The instigator of the deeper, being able to go deeper with men, starts with you. And that is, how connected are you with yourself? How happy or alive you are? How vulnerable? How self-expressed? The way you show up is everything. So when you show up and your state is one of openness, everything will flow significantly different than if you show up and you're just bored, or you're sad, or you're just like closed off or pissed off about something. So keep that in mind. Number two is, a secret to connect more deeply with a man is to connect and tap into your hunger. Why? Because if you get curious and hungry about him, naturally you'll be able to connect in a way that seems more authentic, that feels more real, that he feels more interesting and more intelligent. Why? Because you're using your intuition and you're using your own hunger and your own values and your own beliefs to go deeper, ask better questions. So if you connect to your hunger, you can ask better questions, but that's something you can practice even before being in front of a guy. This is something that's gonna help you in life, regardless of a love relationship, with your children, with work, with your boss, with anyone. If you learn to ask better questions, you will have a richer quality of answer that can let you know so much more about who this man is. For example, if your regular question simply is, well, what do you do for a living? Okay, that's an interesting question, I guess, to get to basics, but what do you love most about what you do is far deeper than what do you do. And I'm not saying you shouldn't ask the first one, but have the courage to ask the second one. What do you love most about what you do? If you could change anything about your life right now, what would you change? what do you find most meaningful in your past? Or what do you feel? If you could relieve any day of your life, which day would it be? Like, be willing to get outside of your comfort zone and ask questions that can give you answers that can let you know more about the man. It's not just the answer he gives you, it's what he shares and what he doesn't share. It's the emotional state that he reacts to you or with that question. You'll be able to see him light up with certain things and close off on certain things, and you'll be able to capture all of that in your heart and get a much better read than if you ask the common, basic, bullshit, boring questions that most people ask each other, and then they wonder why they're bored out of their heads when they connect. Number four. Embody a wider range. And the range that I'm recommending for you right now to start practicing, it's a practice, it's a discipline to be able to step into this, because it's not most natural to most people. Most human beings that I've connected with are either predominantly more playful and relaxed or predominantly more deep. Here's the actual power in being able to do both. You're so freaking unique in the eyes of that man. If you can be playful and relaxed and at the same time have the capacity to go deep, if you have that range, playful versus deep, That's pretty unique because a lot of women are mainly playful and they're not going deep, or many women are just super deep and asking those tough questions, but they can't seem to relax and have fun and enjoy it. And if you can do both and it requires some practice, you will stand out in that level of connection, and he will be able to bring out parts of himself that he's not bringing up maybe necessarily at the beginning. Number five, be vulnerable one step at a time. What does that mean? A lot of women have the fear of, if I'm vulnerable with him and then he leaves, I'm going to be hurt. If he uses that against me, then I'm going to be hurt. So I'm just not going to. So they make the decision, okay, it's like an on and off switch, vulnerable versus not vulnerable. And I think if you think of it that way, you're doing yourself a disservice. My recommendation, if you want to go deeper with men, is that you step into 5% more vulnerability than you were stepping into regularly, which means you're going to feel slightly scared. But it's going to feel more exciting for you because you're being putting more on the table. You're not sharing everything about you. You're sharing more than you usually do. So you share a little bit more, and then you allow him to receive it, to react, to show presence, to show intelligence, and then share something with you. So every step of the way, you can go on 5%, 2% increments in vulnerability and get a chance to express a lot more than if you're just on and off. Because if you're, the other alternative is, I'm an open book and I share everything with him, and you're not sure if he really is worthy of him receiving your deepest secrets. So if you do vulnerability stronger than right now, step at a time, he is gonna feel something from you, and he's going to start gradually, organically, coming closer and closer, and also sharing more and more with you. Now, if you notice that you're vulnerable and sharing things, and he never shares things with you, and you ask him the questions, and he still doesn't want to go there, then move on. Number six, hold space in your heart. If you listen to nothing else that I shared with you, but the number one and number six right now, number one, which is the state is everything, and number six, hold space in your heart. This means that as you're communicating with him, as you're speaking, as you're having this conversation, as you're having fun, asking questions, going deep, going playful, you take a deep breath and hold space in your heart to receive what he's giving to you, and to almost like ask the question, what is this man in front of me feeling? Can I right now, even for a brief second, be empathetic enough that I can feel what he's feeling right now? And it requires presence, it requires silence. But if you can hold space in your heart, if he can get that feeling that you're receiving him more, again, that puts you in a completely different level of communication. It's not something you're doing, it's who you're being when you're with him. That starts chipping in his head, punching him in the head, saying, this woman is unique, this woman is different, and she's not just manipulating me into it. This is who she is. She allows herself the time and the presence to hold space for me. I feel seen, I feel heard, I feel understood. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful for you in some way. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Thing number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Thing number two, subscribe to my channel. And if you want to be notified of new episodes, click on the little bell once you subscribe and you will receive a message when my new videos come out. Thing number three, and most important of all, part one. If you want to go deeper on what I'm sharing with you right now, I created a free masterclass for you. You go to the first line under the description of this video, click on the link, enter your name and email, and you'll be taken there right now, and it's totally free. If you're saying to yourself, I love what you share with me, and the videos are awesome, I need more. I need more hand-holding, I need more specific, customizable questions and answers. I want to go deeper because I really don't have an extra 5 to 10 years to waste trying to trial and error this thing. Help me out to step into the most alive version of myself and to get the soulmate that I want. Then apply to connect with me and see if we can work together. There's a second link under the description of this video that will allow you to fill out a little application. I'll read every one of them. If I can feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out, set up a time to talk, and then we'll go from there. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.